It was a really ridiculous show. That's why MTV made that move. It was like, yo, we got to go ridiculous.
That show, remember Room Raiders?
I don't remember Room Raiders.
You get kidnapped and put in a van. Three fellas, three ladies.
It was another like a relationship, dating show.
Yeah, you get kidnapped and then they would pick you based on going through your room.
Shut up. Yeah. What? I ain't never seen this.
Yeah, Room Raiders was so phenomenal. Good. You never seen that, Dan?
I've never seen that.
It's coming, like, literally again. Hold on. Like,
so they went in through our room.
So they would go. You're right.
So, like, a fake person would, like, put up. You're kidnapped. And then you're in a van with three other people.
Okay. And you watch it.
And you're watching them go through your room.
Crazy. Like,
this guy has a lot of
stop right there. Freeze. Do you know? Did you clean and prep? How spontaneous this is?
Tied a key to a kite, sent it up, and it pulled our sound waves out of the atmosphere. Thank you so much.
Everyone up in Flowery Branch rucks and preps.
What?
Yep.
What was the first one?
Rucks. Just keep going.
My name is Nathan Owens. You can find me on Twitter at Nate Owens Comedy. Instagram, TikTok, Nathan Owens Comedy, NathanOwensComedy.com. David produced with me.
What's up, everybody? Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at doordiders at DUEORDIE.
And, of course, Damon.
What's going on, good people? Get out on Instagram, TikTok, Damon Jr. 2, DAMONJR at the number 2.
And how do we do it? We got everybody in the building 3 episodes in a row. It's Dan amazing. Duncan's here.
At Dan Dunk, rucking is when you put on a military pack and you're not in the military and you go for a very long walk.
Mm. So hiking.
Kind of. But like you do it on everywhere. Just say streets.
So homeless.
Why people catching strays? They trying to eat and have a good meal. Just minding their business.
It just feels like you're like, I'm not homeless, I'm rucking.
What I'm going to say is going to be counterproductive to how I've lived my life and things that I've said on stage, what I'm about to say. Uh-uh. But I need white people to start having more meetings. to talk about
assembling
what
more.
Y'all putting out there in the world. Because I feel like y'all don't really know how it's being perceived or what's going on. And I'm normally anti-white people meet
up. We're normally off that.
But I feel like structure
and supervision.
Meeting up, it's kind of necessary.
It's a New Year's resolution for white people. More meetings.
Supervise.
Supervise.
That was the problem in the past.
They were just doing it without supervision.
I don't know.
Are you volunteering?
It's not y'all.
It can't be me. It can't be me.
Yeah, we may need to go outside higher.
Yeah, it can't be me, yeah.
Let's figure it out. Y'all, let us know. Tweet at us.
The South Carolina guy who ran for president?
Mm. Definitely not him.
Definitely not him.
He worked for the other side.
Speaking of, Candace. Be sure to go to patreon.com, patreon.com/4th and 10. Become a
patron. She's holding the meeting. She's already holding the meeting.
She's got a lot of meetings on our calendar, unfortunately.
Please stop meeting.
Yeah. You can join our exclusive Slack channel. With her.
I told you I'm doing hot takes. Sometimes
I agree
with her.
That's not a hot take. That's just all right. Patreon.com/4th and 10.
I'm not mad at agreeing with her. I don't, but.
We got fantasy leagues going
keep
on
going,
there.
Man.
I think we're in the midst of our
bowl pick. He
doesn't
realize that if he doesn't get into a topic,
just gonna keep
like,
going.
We're just going to talk.
Yeah.
Just going.
I'm
just, you got to get to it.
I'm just trying to go. All right.
Do you want this all to be about Candace Owens? You better start talking about something.
Come on, baby.
Candace Owens and Ben Shapiro about to pop into this podcast.
Oh, man. We not hitting.
Let me tell you what I dislike about minorities. All right.
Why do you have such a good?
Why was that such an on point? You practiced that in the mirror? That was too good.
I love how he has.
All you got to do is just pitch up your voice.
I love how he has a Ben Shapiro, but he doesn't have a Dragonfly Jones!
You son of a gun.
Aaron Gordon went on a bad date.
Yes.
First topic.
No, he didn't. He went on a great date.
So, Aaron Gordon, Nuggets
depends on
champion.
How you look at it.
Nuggets champion.
Champion.
Dunk champion.
Dunk champ. Maybe the greatest dunk contest of all time.
Top three.
Could be for
arguably.
Sure.
He goes on a date with a girl.
Yep. Fun guy.
Said the last thing, he looked at her phone, and when she pulled it out. He didn't, like, steal her phone.
Sure.
But the last thing that she had on her phone was, quote, Aaron Gordon's net worth.
Had to be a search engine inquiry.
It must have been Google.
Yeah.
Or she just had a tab pulled up
yep.
already.
Yeah.
So this begs the question, would that be a good or bad thing? Because to me, that's terrible. Saying, you know what? She's vetting me a little bit.
No.
You know, she's checking it out. Like, I think financially, if you're going to go the distance with somebody, no. You're going to have to get.
What does distance mean to you?
Just if you're going to be in a long-term relationship.
That's what Aaron was looking for?
I don't know.
Was looking for?
Look, I'm not going to assume they were out there just looking for a one-night stand.
I didn't say they were.
I didn't say that.
What does distance mean for you?
I think if you're looking for a relationship, you're going to have to be financially honest with somebody. I don't know.
Hey,
honestly.
I'm going to look in the camera. I don't know your name, young lady.
Uh-oh.
But that must have been your first day on the job as someone who's trying to bag a baller. Because if that man, Aaron Gordon, who is 6'8".
Come on, talk about it.
You know what I mean? 240 pounds in great shape.
Great shape.
Right? I'm pretty sure he didn't take you to McDonald's.
Nope.
I think you just need to be along for the ride.
That's
you don't true. Like, I'm not saying you don't need to know what type of person he is.
Okay.
I'm saying don't Google how much he's worth. Just assume that this is probably better than some dude trying to holler at you at the mall. Like, live in the moment.
So where's the line in the sand? Because I think her figuring out, okay, probably slid in some DMs. Probably got on this guy's radar somehow.
Sure.
Making some assumptions.
Sure.
But
assumption
there's a lot of professional athletes out there that if you probably should Google and figure out what type of behavior they have in their past.
That part's true.
And so what she should have done is understand that's going to be one of the things that like pops up in the algorithm is like how much this guy's worth.
Sure.
With everything else that comes with it. She just needed to simplify her search to be like.
Mm. That's key. Because Aaron she searched Gordon. The wrong thing. Mm. Murderer? That's what she
right.
should have been.
Right.
Did you mean
rapist?
Assault? That, yeah. Wrong. You're wrong words.
Now,
at
he's
hand,
not. He's a good.
No, Aaron no, Gordon, no, ball counts.
Now, what I'm saying, let me be very
ball
clear,
counts.
Is that all specifically, let me be very specific because there is a piece of the puzzle. If you are anybody trying to potentially pursue a fella, all right, especially
you
if they got
know.
Muscles, mm-hmm. you got to make sure you're
Nate
safe,
needed to
one.
Do this with Libby,
okay.
more on the financial side, but
oh, no, I wasn't
stay in general.
I wasn't vetting anything.
I'm here for it. Oh, he was trying to get anything he could find.
I was like, please, legally,
anything.
Let's legally tie each other
you
to
you said this man dressed up as Batman trying to chase. But anyway, let's
tie each other to what? Legally tie each other to what? Finish that sentence.
Finances.
Okay. Finances.
Okay, that's not where I thought we were going there.
He doesn't go there either.
Yeah, you didn't.
Wherever you think.
The only thing you might have questioned was like, who your people? You just want to make sure. Like, who your kin?
They're trying to get school. Married.
What type of white in. People sit behind you?
Oh, I meant, like, are we related?
Church choir.
I meant that.
I knew we weren't related.
You got to be searching for single guys out here in the streets. You can't trust them. There's documentaries out there. You cannot trust them.
Not to be trusted.
What is something that if you were on a date and you saw a woman Googling about you that would offend you?
I'm not famous enough to be Googled.
I guess like David, would you be weirded out if you saw somebody that had pulled up your videos or any of your clips?
Would I be weirded out? Nah, but that day wouldn't go well. I'm like, oh, you a fan. You can't have that. I need you to hate me a little bit.
A little bit.
Otherwise, I'm not gonna be the man also, I need to be.
Also, this is 101 phone technique.
Yeah.
You gotta know how to use your phone.
100%.
If I pull my phone out right here, bet money Dan won't be able to see what's on my phone.
Thanks.
Control your phone be so dark. It'd be so low light.
Yeah.
I'm like, can you see? She's like, yeah, that's not for anybody else to see.
Yeah.
It could be just bank account information. It could be email.
Okay.
Why would I just open it up and like, oh.
Yeah.
That was a poor move, baby girl.
That's why I said this is her first day on the job.
The only reason that it may have been a good move is if he pushed back on paying for everything.
If he pushed back on paying for everything?
If like the check comes and he's like, so we just going 50-50? And then she goes, hold on a second. Let me Google your net worth because you're picking up this entire check. Maybe there was something like that.
A guy still paying fully for meals in 2023, 2024?
Yeah.
We're being extraordinarily generous about why this happened. And for him, this is a good thing.
What you talking
because
about?
he knew that this is a signal of like, I am here for a consensual.
A good time.
Good time.
I'm here for a good time.
And
not for
by that
time.
Search inquiry, the answer she wanted to get, she got.
Oh, she got.
And it
was
a good time.
I wonder what that number was that she could have saw and was like, this ain't it.
This ain't it.
That's
this
a fun question.
Yeah,
this
what
ain't
was that
it.
Number? Because I guarantee he's way more than that
eight
number.
Figures.
Oh, he's.
Oh, he's exponential. I mean, I would guess. In
he's
the
probably
nine,
close to
nine
a, yeah.
figures.
He's probably close to 100 million.
I mean, so his current salary is 21.2 million.
He ain't got to get in my man's pockets. We know he doing
this
well.
This is interesting. I'm curious. Because I wouldn't have been able to tell you.
Yeah, 21.2 million.
career earnings.
He's in the second year of a 4-year deal with the Nuggets.
Okay.
So his career earnings is probably over 100.
Very well.
Yeah. And he has got some deals.
Yeah, and he was in that trash.
It has to be at minimum seven figures.
Yes.
Yeah, she's not going out here with lawyers. Okay.
No.
Totally.
You on a bus? Oh, yeah. No. Get out of here. Now we got to do this. Your face is on a park bench? I can't do it.
I think it's eight figures or nothing.
For her? You think that was for her?
Yeah. Because if we split it.
Well, you know, Paul Pierce. I
got to stay seven.
You know, Paul Pierce says, you know there's a website. You know there's an app for this. I know you could just walk out at Courtside and be like, hey, you want a hot, you know, bop da bop. Like, nah, I'd just rather, like, you know, Uber Eats. And just kind of just, whoop.
I think dudes that money should just be buying,
behind the boop.
It is.
Matchmakers.
Who?
You need matchmakers.
Matchmakers.
Yeah, pay for a matchmaker.
That's what's going down in 2024?
That was a whole TV show. It was about matchmakers. Yeah, I didn't watch it, but I know it existed.
Wasn't Hitch a matchmaker?
Yeah.
Yes.
No, he wasn't a matchmaker. Oh. He got your game right.
Matchmakers
go essentially like, here's a pool of women that I vetted.
Okay.
Have similar interests. And you should go on these dates.
Would you work with a matchmaker?
It
sounds like an offer.
No.
No?
No.
Hmm.
I don't trust people. So I wouldn't do it.
I do think a good relationship, you can't be a fan and be in a good relationship.
Fan.
Yeah.
Like, there is this 1-2 punch where you're like, you're gonna punch back at me.
I need that.
And I think friction. fans kind of put
sure.
You people up on a pedestal.
No wrong.
Right.
Yeah. God. Yeah.
I know me. I'm very wrong.
Yeah.
I
need
someone to say you're wrong.
Yeah. I will say this. One of the worst days I ever had was I was on a date with this girl and she was like, I don't find Dave Chappelle funny. And I remember feeling my body, my soul leave.
Well, stand up.
And I stayed in the date, and I just continued. This was before all. This was like 20.
Oh, this is ages ago.
Yeah, this is before.
I was about to ask what year we
were. Before it was questionable to say this.
I was about to ask.
Right? Yeah. But she was like, no. Specifically, she was like, I didn't like Chappelle's show. And I felt my soul leave the taco place we was eating at.
Yeah.
And I was there physically. But I was like, this is the last time I've ever been to see you. I'm sorry to say that, boo-boo. We are never going to go to another
deal breaker.
I was like, you don't know what funny is. So I'm out.
Oh, the deal breakers.
Yeah.
We should talk deal breakers.
Oh, yeah. Goodness gracious.
Oh, yeah.
And next. That's what all I'm thinking of right now is the show next. I miss that show.
Next.
I miss that show. Bro,
MTV's
so much.
Era.
Wow.
Next.
I haven't thought about that show in 20 years.
It was such,
MTV had some hits.
Such a simple concept.
Very simple.
If you don't like this person, yell next.
Out loud.
Out loud.
In the air.
In their face.
Also, so I caught, like, I saw. Like,
you tried to get casted?
No. It was either a TikTok or something I saw the other day. I forgot that it was just $1 a minute.
Yeah.
What?
So yeah, people were only winning like $15.
Yeah.
Oh, I forgot that was money involved.
There was money involved, yeah.
So I forgot that was money involved.
It only got to the point they capped it at $60.
Yeah,
so they were like, you can walk away with $60 right now.
$60?
Or you can go on a second date.
$60 went a lot further than 2002.
This is also true. That's true.
Okay,
but not that far.
Right. We're still talking $120.
But I just love that these guys were getting like, ended up with like, $4 or $5 and then probably had to pay taxes on it.
Oh my
like,
goodness.
They got a check from MTV that was like
$2.68. That's insanity.
That's being crazy, on bro. Next.
Next.
Yeah.
It was a really ridiculous show. That's why MTV made that move. It was like, yo, we got to go ridiculous.
That show, remember Room Raiders?
I don't remember Room Raiders.
You get kidnapped and put in a van. Three fellas, three ladies.
It was another like a relationship,
yeah,
dating
you get kidnapped,
show.
Okay. And then they would pick you based on going through your room.
Shut up.
Yeah.
What? I ain't never seen this.
Yeah, Room Raiders was
so
phenomenal.
Good.
You never seen that, Dan?
I've never seen that.
It's coming like literally again.
Hold on.
Like,
so they went
it's
through our
out of the
room.
Fog
yeah, so,
in my memory.
Yeah, so
like,
they would go.
You're right.
So
I
like a fake person would like
this.
Put up. You're kidnapped, and then you're in a van with three other people.
Okay.
And you watch it.
And you're watching them go through your room.
Crazy.
And be like, this guy has a lava
lamp. Stop right there. Freeze. Do you know? Did you clean and prep? How spontaneous
sure
is this?
Did, but some people clearly didn't.
Yeah.
Okay, carry on.
Yeah, and they're like, this guy has a lava lamp. I'm sure he's in for a good time. Some
2002
like
type of vibe.
My favorite episode is one dude lived with his mom.
Okay.
And the mom didn't seem prepared.
Okay.
She's just in the kitchen. And this girl and camera crew walk in.
Shut your mouth.
And she's like, hello? And she's like, where's your son's room? And she's like, over there. And then the girl turns to the camera. She's like, lives with his mom. Not great. And I'm like, he's like 19.
Nate's like, this is my future for the next 12 years.
Yeah, I was like, give him a chance.
Give him a chance.
Shame on that mom. If you don't know these people, like, man, y'all get out of my house. I tell you where my son is at, you psycho.
You insane?
Yeah. My favorite episode ever. This is such a great show. And this has been in my brain forever. Is that a girl found a dead bird in one guy's room and picked him.
Oh no.
What?
They are happily together. Because
it was the craziest thing. She was just like, she's on his desk. She's like, is this a dead bird?
Like, and taxidermy then, dead, or just like under some sheets of stuff?
It's like taxidermy dead, but it wasn't like on a platform or like on the wall. It's just like tipped over on his dresser.
That's why you got to Google single guys. This is it right here?
Yeah.
This is right here. Dead bird.
Dead bird. And the guy was like, oh no, I left my bird out. Like, he was real. He was embarrassed that he left it out, not that he had just a dead. And it was like a crow, too. It wasn't even like a cool big old bird.
It was a black dead bird?
Yeah, it wasn't like a duck.
Oh,
no.
He's got toes in the jaw somewhere.
Who's
you gotta watch out for that
duck.
All right,
put that on the grill.
That's crazy.
So it we are headed into the new year.
We're heading into 2024.
What is your New Year's resolution, or maybe better, what is one thing you're leaving in this year, and maybe make it tangentially sports related.
Ooh.
Oh man.
Something we're leaving in 2023 or desire to
dance.
What you got, brother?
So this past year, I only got to two live sporting events.
Okay.
And my son is finally at the age where we get to
come
to do that.
Come on.
2024 is the year of we doing live sports.
We out there. I like that.
We're going to soccer matches, football games, basketball games, baseball games.
Love that.
The live entertainment.
Yeah,
it feels like we're like exiting the COVID. The final, like,
maybe
we don't,
remnants,
like, you
se.
Don't, you just stop thinking about that for two
yeah.
years. Like, this is something we're going to, you know, invest time in doing.
Sure.
But this year's
like
the year of live sports.
We gambling.
Oh.
We gambling.
Oh, that's changing in Georgia.
I'm missing out on too much money. I'm too good with the sports thoughts. I've been seeing people make all type of money out here in the streets.
I saw a story about a guy in jail.
Yes.
That won his bail.
Bail money. Off of sports gambling.
Yeah, he hit.
He was like, hit,
he got
hit
10,000.
Yeah.
Like 10,000 and got out of jail.
Bruh,
because, and I said,
you either.
We've gone too far. Listen,
by March, I'm either.
In a dystopian reality.
Yeah.
By March, I'm either going to come in with six more chains or I can't afford the drive to be on this podcast. It's one of the two.
Yeah.
I'm not playing. We out here gambling in the streets. We're starting small just to get the understanding of how it works. But I be seeing the stuff people hit on. Yeah, I was thinking. Let's get this money up. I'm trying to retire my wife. Let's get this up.
Similar to Dan's, I don't think I went to a sporting event this year.
Okay.
But I realized that I'm only going to sporting events if it's like, you know me, I'm bougie.
There it is.
Luxury.
There it is.
I'm only going if it's like, I was somewhere, I was watching some game and it just hit me. I think I saw the seats and people up there. And I said, I'll never be back up there. I'll never be back up
when you
there.
Say I'm not ever going to look at Frontier Spirit flights again, it's like that.
Me. Yeah.
I know
never.
It's been that way for you,
yes.
But for people,
yes.
You have to make those decisions. You said, I'm out to 300s.
I'm out to, I'm never going to do that again.
I like this.
So
he's out to 300s, people.
You can invite me, but if the ticket's not.
it's a revelation when you're on a plane and you, like, get bumped to first class and you go back to the like, economy comfort, like, the second level, and you're like, I can't do this.
That's why I'm glad I've never been first class. I've never been first class.
I've never been in first class.
Once
and I'm happy.
Once you break that seal, it is.
Because I know myself. Every time Dev's like, you know you can upgrade. I can't. And I would do it. And I don't need to do that right now. Yeah.
What you got, Nate?
Man, I mean, y'all. I hate saying y'all took mine, but I wanna see more. I wanna watch more sports that I'm not as invested in.
For example,
like, you wanna be the Tennessee fan that went to the SEC championship and wore their gear.
I wouldn't say wear the gear.
What is this fool doing?
I wanna be able to enjoy sports more. And
I think you should do that.
It's just it's too much.
You don't think you enjoy sports?
I don't think you should do that.
I don't think any of us could do that.
I love how we all went around like, yeah. And they went, we're like, no, we need to have an intervention.
You're like, hold on, wait, that's a bad goal.
I think you enjoy sports too much.
So much.
The problem is I don't enjoy them, and I still put in a lot of time. It hurts. I'm hurting.
When do you enjoy? When do you not enjoy them? Like with the Falcons?
I don't.
It's like emotional cutting.
Yeah. That's what I'm trying. I'm trying to
like it's
help.
A problem.
Yeah, dog.
I'm trying to help myself with toxic sports like you, relationships.
Oh, so you want to care less about the Falcons?
I want, yes. I don't think I, and the, well, that's the problem.
You might have to throw your TV away.
That's a I don't know how to wind this down.
Oh, boy.
I don't know how to wind this down.
That's how you get on lists. Yeah.
I think you just have realistic.
I can tell you how you do it.
Uh-oh. Talk to him.
You have realistic expectations.
Ooh.
The Hawks are not going to win the NBA championship
ever.
This year.
You don't know
the
that.
You see that trauma talking?
You're not there. If you want to tell me, you want to tell me in August that they didn't win.
I will tell you.
That's fine. We'll talk.
I am happy for you to put up no money and for me to risk substantial amounts of money. Talking about sports betting,
come on.
That the Falcons and the Hawks will not win a championship, not this year, not the next year, and not the year after.
Putting a bet on layaway? Like,
no, I'm just saying, like, they will not win for the next 3 years, and that's because they don't, they're not building towards winning.
I like how you looked at what he said and thought he was unreasonable. And you presented us with the most unreasonable way of thinking.
I want to hurt myself less. Yeah. And everything y'all saying makes no sense.
The Braves built for longevity and future, and like they will be back. But dude, the Hawks. If you can understand that the Falcons are a 4-8 team.
Yeah.
You can walk into that season and be like, we're 4-8 team. If we go
the mentality. Like, gotta be together.
Well, I guess it's an 8. I guess you have 16 in that.
Sure, we understand
what
you're saying.
The point is we're an under 500 team.
Okay.
If you can go in and be like, if we go 500 or above,
right here,
we're winning. I'm winning.
That's not.
I got more wins
than
losses.
If you don't believe in them, who will?
What's your thought?
Their goal isn't championships right now.
Based on who you have been as a person, your history,
okay,
all of that.
Yeah.
I'm going to say keep sports in your life.
Okay.
Because I feel like Nate has always been on that. If he didn't have sport, who would he be?
Boy.
And like, I don't want to think about what you call rucking. Nate would get into rucking.
No.
Nate should get into rucking.
He should, but we know he won't.
I'm just going to put on a backpack and walk around. That was the worst description of any activity I've ever heard.
And we know you're not going to get
it. It's for those that can't – I mean, in reality, it is a hard exercise for those that don't want to run, can't run, so on and so forth.
Do you run?
A lot.
Huh? I can.
You can?
No. You cannot run.
You can run? Hold on, slow down. This is the topic of the day. You can run?
Yes, I can run.
Okay, no, hold on. Let me say what I mean by running.
Let's slow down. I can't run faster.
This is
for
the Falcons can win a championship and I can run.
I want to be clear.
These statements are the same.
I can't run fast or for very long.
So you can't run?
But I can run.
No. That's running.
You can sprint.
I don't know if that's sprinting. I think you might be able to power walk. You think you can run?
I can run.
Run where?
I can run across a parking lot if I need to.
Run?
We have a parking lot here.
I think you can probably jog really well.
I've run to catch a plane before.
You ran?
Yeah.
I think he's right. I think the definition of a power walk is 1 foot is on the ground at all times, and the definition of run is at one point in time both feet are off the ground. I would run. I struggle to believe that you
run?
Get to the run category.
Yeah. Oh, no, bro.
It's not a good run.
No,
but it is a run.
Are you willing to put this on camera?
I'll take this camera out of the park right now.
I haven't stretched.
Bro, there's not a lot of things I'd be like, I got to see this to believe it.
The only
on this
time
podcast.
Someone walks something back as fast as that is they're like, I stepped too far.
Wait a second.
I got to stretch.
You couldn't prove that you could run?
I could. I don't have good shoes.
Oh, boy. You see that?
My hammies are tight. I haven't even eaten breakfast.
When's the last time you ran? Like, legitimately, you remember I ran.
Is middle school?
I've run.
High school ball. He played ball in high school.
I've run across streets before.
That's not running. We're talking two different things. First off, if you have to run across the street, you're getting hit.
Okay, can we?
Because that car is too close.
Okay, because we need to describe something. Like, because even great athletes, like, it's so funny to me when you watch college football players.
Okay.
And like the plays, they just ran a 4 flat in a 40.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden, when they're going back to the huddle, it looks like they are incapable of like moving their body in like a organized fashion.
For sure.
The waddle kind of like power run walk thing comes out. That's what I imagine you're running across the street is like this uncoordinated run walk hybrid. That doesn't count as running.
Has Libby ever seen you run?
Has Libby ever seen me run?
And also, to qualify as running, I think you have to do it for more than a minute.
I'm going
to
text her right now.
Okay. She had. There's no way Libby's seen me run.
No. Okay. What's what? You have to. You
Where
have to
she
do
have
it
seen me run?
For 100 yards.
What?
100 yards is
the,
running?
The shortest sprint in the world.
A whole football field?
I can, is 100
that
yards.
That man is not running a football field.
I can jog a football field. I'm not going to. I'm not. I can't
you
sprint.
You can't run. The
I can't
point,
sprint
the, this
for 100
topic
yards.
Started is that you couldn't run. That you don't. You can't run. You're incapable of it.
I can run. I well, cannot I mean, run for very long or very fast.
One, I don't believe it. Two, I want to be clear. Running. All jokes aside, running is a skill. I know people who can't skip. Like, there's things mentally.
Skip. He said that with so much confidence. All right,
okay.
There's
hey,
people
hey,
mentally
hey,
and physically
which
I'm not going to say I
can't
do a skip.
This started because Nate, who eats McDonald's and Wendy's, or doesn't eat Wendy's anymore because it's too expensive.
It can be.
Was crapping on someone doing a physical exercise wearing a weighted backpack.
No, I'm laughing at them rebranding walking around. That's what it
it's
is.
Not
just like
I mean, kind of it is.
You
and
did.
I,
you tried to make walking around more impressive, where it's like, just say
Nate,
you're on
if
a
if you
hike.
Were to walk, if you were to walk every day for like an hour, you would be in better shape than you are today. So yeah. I don't know why you're crapping on that.
Because I wouldn't rebrand it as I'm doing something incredible. I'd just be like, I'm just
it
walking
is a
around.
You wear a weighted vest yes, to
that,
do it.
That part.
I've been wearing a weighted vest my entire life.
That was on the whole. That was on the whole.
You give me a weighted vest. There's nothing impressive about
that. Was on that. That was only a piece of the puzzle. Because I thought we were going to enter
something
into
more than your egregious body weight.
I got a weighted vest on my front. Like, I got a backwards backpack on that
yeah.
I have to wear.
And you're not
every
running
single
in
day.
It, okay?
Like, back what to the point now.
So let's stay focused here. Yo, what the real that wasn't even a real issue. He tried to side track you.
I'm going to come home after Allison listens to this episode. She's like,
listen.
She always says it. You're too hard on Nate.
Listen.
And I'm going to hear it again.
You can't get sidetracked here. Shout out to Allison. That was a tier two issue. The real issue was that he threw out a goal that we all were like, no, and then he started backtracking in the trauma. That's what I want to make sure we're clear. Yeah. I want to make sure
let
the listeners.
Let's not forget.
Let's not get sidetracked
and
that are here, okay?
To run on camera.
In conclusion.
All right,
okay?
next time.
Nah, bro, you're stretching it. Right after this episode.
Next time we record,
all got phones.
I'll wear shoes that I can run in.
What do you got on right now?
These are just dunks.
You think people don't run in dunks? You think people in Africa are not running because they don't have dunks?
I don't think they don't.
Is that
don't
what you're saying?
I think
okay.
they don't.
You're telling me run. Ethiopians are not getting ready for marathons because they don't have dunks
in the
on.
First week
is that
of
what you're
January,
saying?
There is a park. There's a park with a track next to my house, Phoenix Park.
I don't
Anyone
it.
That wants to come can
I don't
come.
Believe it.
I will be there. You will be there. I will pay you $10 every 100 yards, meters, whatever, like a quarter of the track.
We're Americans.
400 meters. Every 100 meters, we are Americans. Every 100 meters, I will pay you $10 that you can go.
Every lap?
Yes. That you run. You cannot stop running.
Don't
the second you stop moving your body where both feet are off the ground at one point in time in that motion.
I don't.
He can't. I don't. I'm not going to spend a dollar. I know. I realize.
I'm saying this in love.
I mean, it's going to be a pretty slow jog at one point.
That's not a run. We're not going to spend our last episode
right,
2023 talking about
just,
whether you can run or not
just,
run.
Nobody just sprints a mile out of nowhere.
No.
Like,
I'm saying you cannot run
those are athletes.
At all.
Right. And
not, not 100 meters.
And that's what I'm pushing
not
back
to,
at.
Right. And you should. I don't believe it.
I think what you think well, run is and what he think runs is.
Yes.
Two
that's what I'm saying.
What I just think is funny is like I just think that you being
as confident as
you are
as
right
is.
Now
is.
Without literally saying like – anyone that can do something, even like at a low level, if they're challenged in the way that we're challenging you right
like,
now,
yeah, I do it.
They would say like, "Screw it! I don't care if I pull a hammy
do right
doing
now.
This. I'm gonna prove y'all
right
wrong."
Now.
And somewhere deep inside your soul, you died, and
you can't let it.
I've seen too many videos of people talking like this, and then pulling a hammy, tearing
pull
an
a
Achilles,
hammy, and prove
I can't
us wrong.
Pull a hamstring.
He can't pull a ham. He'll be homeless.
Why? What are you gonna do? You're gonna sit on the couch and watch football? Wait.
I got chores I gotta do the rest of the day. We got family coming in Saturday.
This is, now you didn't even sound embarrassing. Now you sound embarrassing.
I gotta get cleaning done. I need my legs for the next few days. I can't pull a hamstring.
I need my legs, Nate.
Next time we reconvene in 2024, I will wear running shoes. Mm. I'll do a little bit of stretch.
You don't even own running
shoes. I'll have a granola bar.
You own running shoes?
I don't know.
Let's move along. Let's move along. Okay. It's not gonna happen.
I just bought.
He should have shaved his chest and been punched in the face 3 years ago. It's not gonna happen. It's okay.
You're gonna start cold plunging with me. We're gonna get you right.
I actually would do a cold plunge.
Dan, can you run?
Yes.
Okay. David, can you run?
No.
You see how easy that was? Do you see how easy that was? No. It's called humility. Okay, I can't make a steak. It's fine. Because I can say it out loud. I don't change my own tires. I can't change the oil. I don't know what an alternate is.
Here's the point.
It's fine.
Here's the point. If you can go to the last time you did it, for me, it was yesterday, that you did something, you can say you did it. If you cannot physically remember the last time you did it, you more than likely cannot.
Yeah, it's in 2023.
You ran this year?
In 2023.
No, I did not run this year.
We got to go. We got to move. We got to move.
Not for long. Across a crosswalk.
Stop it.
Or like to catch my dog.
I love how
he
remembers the crosswalk.
That's not a run,
New Year's resolutions and Nate can't run. That's the title of this episode.
Yeah.
What else we got? Let's talk about Y2K. I was like,
okay, that's great.
We do have New
great
Year's work. Coming up.
Yeah, we do.
Now we're coming up on the 24th anniversary of Y2K.
Ooh.
I know it's a big deal to everybody. Now, I don't – we talk about
forget.
Where were you when?
Jeez.
Do y'all remember the Y2K, the 1999? The thing that I remember about it is my little brother was born in December of 1999.
Mm.
And apparently there were a lot of women in the hospital that my mom said were screaming at doctors to not deliver babies. Because they all wanted to wait a few more weeks and have the millennium baby. They wanted January 1st.
They're trying to shut that womb down.
Yeah.
What a silly thing.
None of those women, that all had to be first children because.
Yeah.
It's an incredibly.
Once that process starts, they want it over as fast as possible.
So there was that. Now, I do remember my parents did not buy into the Y2K.
No?
At all.
Mm.
Didn't prep, didn't buy food.
No prep, no food. If it had happened, we were done.
Y'all were gone.
But I do remember in the last few minutes, my dad was just like, hey, why don't you just go unplug the computer?
last little piece.
The last like 5 minutes, like they're getting ready to drop the peach, and my dad's like, just go unplug the computer.
Just turn it off.
For the people who don't know, what did they say was going to happen?
That's really important. We need a little context.
So they said the banks were only supposed to go through 1999 when they made all this software.
Right.
So people thought that when it went over to 2000, the year 2000, the bank's system was going to
crash
and lose everybody's money. And then electricity was going to crash and like.
Oh, people thought that was nice. People thought the world was going to be over.
The world was
gonna people was like, yo, this is.
Ran out of numbers,
we are not supposed to see 2000.
But that was like the domino that was supposed to fall was like, banks are going to crash, new depression.
Yeah, I am legend.
The Mayan calendar.
All of that.
Yeah.
Like pops
all of
up,
that.
Which it pops up, I feel like,
every
4 years.
Yeah,
every
every Olympics, it's like. Oh,
Mayans predicted this.
Did they?
They're like the Church of Scientology. Because
they didn't have on dunks to run in. So I don't know if they was really knowing what they were talking about.
Mayans, yeah, I don't know if I trust a Mayan calendar.
Yeah, yeah. No, I was 14.
Colored people.
I was 14.
I appreciate the take.
I was 14, and I remember being, with my mom and my brothers here, and it was another day for us.
It was another day.
It was like December 25th at 3 p.m. Like, it was just a regular old day. Yeah. We were not sweating. My mom, we didn't think about it. Of course, a TV and stuff was talked about, but I remember being the oldest of two younger brothers, right, of just like, yeah, like we're not doing anything about it. We ain't going to no church meetings right here. Like nothing was. And when we woke up the next day and realized we were right,
yeah,
and we were not crazy. I just remember us being like, yeah, we knew the whole time.
In my mind, I assumed you were at church,
right? And I was. That's
because
how little.
People, you know what I'm saying? Just that's like it's like a service that you had a midnight service.
That's how little we were even putting. It was like we're not even gonna waste our time in the house of the Lord. All right, with this nonsense and foolishness, the devil will pray him away. But this fake stuff, we're not having it.
I think our family hedged because if I remember correctly, I have a vague memory of like some level of like water, food being pushed into like our basement, like in preparation.
Mm.
But like there wasn't ever like a big conversation as a family, like, hey, we don't know what's gonna happen here. But what's funny is. It like now my dad had like that same like probably wild hair that forced him to buy and prep that food.
Mm.
Like, oh, that man's buying gold. he's doing things that you're just like, this is insanity.
That's funny.
But I think you know, white people know that the good times have to end at some point in time. And
sooner or later.
Who knows what it's going to be.
I don't know if that's true.
No, we know.
There are too many signs where it should have happened and it hadn't.
You know, it's like, what's that Chris Rodbeck from Tambourine? He was talking about Trump. He's like, you know, people can say what comes around goes around. Maybe it don't. Maybe that sometimes don't come.
Yeah. I mean, let's talk about that. We're about to enter in these last 2 minutes into an election year. Is it election year?
I think
February?
So.
Are we back already to that?
Or is it a year?
2024.
We finna get another president in 2024?
I hope so.
Golly, I hope it's... Oh, my goodness.
I just wanted to stop being old people.
No, we won't be.
I just don't know what we're doing. I'm so sick of just a wrinkly old person that doesn't work.
I just think it was a rule. You got to be 35.
Right.
It should be another rule. You got to know how to work the remote.
Got to be a cap.
Bro,
a
cap. I got a call from my dad last night.
Yeah.
Like, I can't turn these closed captions off on my Roku.
Listen, man.
I was like, okay. He called me.
Yeah. He called
me. And I go, I need to see what you're looking at in order to help you. And he goes, how do we do that? I go, let me FaceTime you. And in the same call, hit the button. Uh-huh. And he goes, okay. I'm looking at him like, this is not helpful. Flip the camera around. He goes, how do I do that?
Oh, my God.
And I go, pull up where you see yourself, and there's a little button that, like, flips the camera. Yeah. Hit that. And he's like, okay. Does that. And then... All of a sudden, it's like he forgot how to hold the camera because then all of a sudden, all I see is his legs.
Hey, man, old people got to be stopped.
I'm like, Dad, pick the camera up. Show me the TV. I need you to see the TV through the phone.
My.
All right, cool. We did that.
Boom.
All right, find the button, the star button on the remote. I think that's it for this, you know, program, you know, that or like kind of app that you're in and what he was watching.
Yeah.
And he goes, where's the star button? I'm like, oh, my God.
Come on, man.
Okay, point it back at your leg so I can see the remote again.
Trying to be the leader of the free world.
And, like, bro, literally took 15 minutes to get closed captions.
That's
off
what it
TV.
Is. Forget debates. Can you reset a router?
Bro, forget that. Can you work a phone? I was at a Christmas concert this Saturday.
Boom.
And I knew it was going to be trouble. It was an auntie age lady came in. And she wanted to record. Yep. And she brought in the ring light to record.
The ring light.
So I said, I know she's not about to plug that in.
I know she's not.
So I'm sitting close. I'm the spot.
Yep.
So she puts the ring light in front of me
to
record. And I was like, man, I'll help you.
Yeah.
So I'm not paying attention. Mm. And she has her phone. So imagine ring light here.
Ring light.
She puts the phone here to capture this.
Yep.
I don't know if you see how my phone is.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Screen here.
Camera lens is there.
There. Boom. So I'm like, I know she's not recording me. And I look, and she wasn't. Mm. She wasn't recording me.
She used the bad camera.
Yeah.
So after a while, she keeps coming in, like pausing. Yeah. I said, ma'am.
Baby girl.
I said, you're not even using the right.
The get.
So I said, you should flip it.
Flip that thing.
And she very confidently goes, well, then, baby, just be looking at you. That's what she said to me. And it took everything in me now to go, hey, man, sit your old ass down, man. Stop coming over here. But I had patience. I said, oh, no. See these is cameras. And what you're going to do is we're going to go back, and I'm going to reverse. And I promise you, when I put that reverse button, you would have thought I showed her electricity for the first time. She goes, I ain't never seen nothing like that in all my life.
And all my life.
She was so happy.
Fight.
She was like, I ain't never. This is a new feature. She thought it was a new feature to just flip the camera around. And I was like, she in charge of people.
Charge
She's the
of
age
people.
Of like, y'all do this and y'all do that. And she don't know how to work her phone.
That's it.
Oh, can't have it. I want to love you, but I need y'all to sit down.
I think we need like a 22-year-old Latina woman. I think we just need somebody just out here.
Just a hard reset?
Just a hard reset. We need something different out here. Every time I've met a young Latina woman, I was like, ooh, we could battle. Because it's always
impressive.
A good time. Smart. Yeah. Witty, tactful, little spice, everything impressive. Nice. I'm just saying. We should sleep on that right
now. I'm going to go all the way. Bring them Mexican aliens. That's who I want to run things.
The little guy.
Bring that guy. Find out. Revive one. Rehydrate one of the Mexican aliens.
Rehydrate.
And bring them in charge.
Wait,
we're that tribe people.
Are they Mexican because they're aliens from Mexico?
Yeah, they're from Mexico.
They're buried in Mexico.
Oh, yeah.
I think it's aliens.
I should be more clear.
Their point of origin is unknown.
Yeah, the unknown point of origin, assuming Mars or somewhere out there.
So there's aliens.
That type of alien.
They're aliens by way of Mexico?
They found them in Mexico.
The Mexican government.
Boy, did I get us in trouble.
Or are they just Mexicans who were just out in outer space?
They are.
It's little alien. Right. Classic
when
aliens.
I thought about how this podcast was going to end this year.
Then I throw for a loop.
That one wasn't it.
No, Mexican.
Well, here we go.
Mexican aliens.
Happy New Year. Feliz New Year.
New Year.
For the
Okay. So Nate in 2024 is going to run.
And be less racist.
Period.
Yeah, I'll run.
Less racist. Damon in 2024 is.
Oh, did we not finish that?
Nah, go ahead.
And we stopped at Nate.
Yeah.
I think we did live events. I got through live events, and Nate said he was going to run.
Well, I thought we finished that conversation. No. I forgot what I thought. No, what was the question?
Just real quick. What do you in 2024, I don't know. Dot, dot, dot.
Oh, God, dog it. 2024. I said gambling. That's what I said.
Gambling. Yeah. We're going to win some money.
Yeah, that's what I said. Right. Get the money up.
All right, let us know if you're good at gambling. Help us all out. All right. One more time.
What happened to Owens? Let's talk about
that. You can find me on Twitter. @NathanOwensComedy. Instagram, TikTok, @NathanOwensComedy, or NathanOwensComedy.com.
Yo, follow me @DoorDot. It's @DueOrDie on Instagram and Twitter.
Get at me. Instagram, TikTok. We're trying to take over the world. We finna blow up out here in these streets, got dog. Damon Jr. 2, DAMONJR at the number 2.
I Dan Dunk.
Nope. There we go. Happy 2024.
Hey. Peace.
Kindness yet for